Isabella of Castile was a very famous queen. In 1474, she ascended the throne to rule the Spanish kingdom of Castile. She will always be seen as a strong and determined woman, with a fair skin, light eyes, and blonde hair. She had a delicate and fragile appearance, speaking in a low, soft voice, but with assurance and certainty. Married to Ferdinand II of Aragon, alongside her husband, her reign was marked by numerous transformations in the Spanish nation, preparing it to be a great European power in the 16th century. Isabella was born in Madrigal de las Altas Torres, in the province of Avila, on April the 22nd, 1451. Her parents were Isabella of Portugal and John II of Castile. She had two brothers, Alfonso, younger than her, and Henry, the fruit of her father's first marriage to Mary of Aragon. When Isabella was born, Henry was 26 years old and married to Blanca, a princess of Navarre. He ascended the throne in 1454 when John II died. After her husband's death, Isabella of Portugal moved to Arevalo, a town near Madrigal de las Altas Torres, taking Isabella and little Alfonso with her. As time went by, Isabella of Portugal, feeling an enormous sadness for having lost her husband, became a silent, reclusive, and isolated woman. The girl, to escape that unhappy situation, ended up approaching the Catholic religion. During all of this, Isabella of Castile's maternal grandmother, Isabella de Barcelos, arrived in Arevalo. She became a support and an important female figure during her granddaughter's childhood. Meanwhile, Henry reigned in Castile. He was a king who hated ceremonies, preferring to live in isolation and dress quite simply, without extravagances which did not match his noble role. In addition, he had sympathies for Moors and Jews, which caused great discomfort to some people who associated these groups with local stories that they were dangerous and cruel people. To make matters worse for Henry, it was said that he was not committed to Christianity. Because Henry had no children with Blanca, and was even nicknamed Henry the Impotent, the union was annulled by Pope Nicholas V. He later married Joan of Portugal. After several years of marriage, Joan finally became pregnant. Then, to keep control over all pretenders to the throne, Henry took his siblings, Isabella and Alfonso, to live with him in Segovia, where the court was. The two children abandoned the happy and carefree life they had in Arevalo. It was 1461. Henry and Joan of Portugal had a daughter named Joanna. Although the monarch considered her his daughter, there were many rumors that the real father of the child was not Henry, but the Castilian nobleman, Beltrán de la Cueva. She even became known as Juana la Beltraneja. Henry liked to do things his way, giving little relevance to the opinions of others. To have influence over the ruler's decisions, the nobles organized the Farce of Avila, a ceremony conducted by them and witnessed by the people. The statue made of wood, representing King Henry, was shown to all present, and a list of accusations was divulged. One of the charges was that Joanna was not the legitimate daughter of the king. Henry, agreeing to have his sister as his successor, signed the Treaty of the Bulls of Guisando in September 1468, a kind of agreement between Henry and Elizabeth. She would be proclaimed Princess of Asturias, meaning she would become the heir to the throne. She then went to live in Ocaña, a small town under Juan Pacheco, Marquess of Villena. Isabella was looking for suitors, and in exchange for her being her brother's successor, Henry would have to prove her future husband. Elizabeth had numerous suitors, and Mary Ferdinand II of Aragon, her second cousin. The marriage took place in October 1469, and the union was celebrated for 7 days in the streets of Valladolid. In fact, Isabella did not respect the agreement made with her brother. King John II of Aragon proposed to her the idea of marrying his son, Ferdinand, and she agreed without informing Henry. She and her fiancé were cousins. The union would be illegal. The marriage was only consummated with the help of the Pope, who was in favor of the marriage. In turn, Henry also disregarded the agreement made with his sister, and gave the title of heiress to his daughter Joanna, and not to Elizabeth, as had been agreed. In 1474, Henry died. Although some wanted Elizabeth in power, others were in favor of Joanna on the throne. There was a huge dispute between the two. Joanna married King Alfonso IV of Portugal, and the Portuguese kingdom sided with her. With the nobility of Castile wanting Isabella as the new queen, the Castilian War of Succession began, lasting between 1475 and 1479. Isabella rose to power, and Joanna remained in Portugal, living in a convent for many years. Isabella was calm about the security of her reign, and no longer feared her rival. Now, Isabella of Castile and her husband had to settle many things side by side. Although Ferdinand had some power, the wife had more, as she was the queen owner of Castile. When it came to government, the two got along very well, collaborating constantly. In married life, Isabella suffered deeply from knowing that her husband had lovers. He seemed to love his wife, but he could not be faithful, and the queen felt awful about the situation. She was always jealous, but tried to conceal her feelings. In 1479, Ferdinand's father died. His son inherited the title of King of Aragon. Isabella and her husband now united to rule, side by side, Aragon and Castile. At this time, they had one heir to these kingdoms, and that was their son, John, born in 1479. In fact, even before John was born, they already had a daughter who was named Elizabeth, just like her mother. They would later have three more girls, Joanna, Mary, and Catherine. During their reign, Isabella of Castile and Ferdinand showed dissatisfaction with the large number of new Christians in Spain. New Christians, also called conversos, were the Jews converted to Christianity. The couple wanted to rule a Christian land and wished to expel the Jews living there. Cities such as Seville, Valladolid, and Barcelona had many Jews among the population, including in important political and religious positions. Isabella of Castile, together with her husband, installed the Spanish Inquisition, or Tribunal of the Holy Office of the Inquisition. The role of this institution was to punish heretics, those who deviated from the teachings of the Catholic Church. The search for heretics began in Seville, a city where there were many Jews. The conversos were presented to the civil authorities who carried out the punishments. In most cases, the heretic was subjected to public shame, but in some situations, they could be cruelly tortured or even killed at the stake. On February the 6th, 1481, the Inquisition claimed its first victims at the stake. Many victims would follow. The institution remained active in Spain until 1834, executing not only Jews, but also Muslims and Protestants. Although the Spanish Inquisition acted to eliminate heretics, the Spanish Kingdom of Granada had been inhabited by many Muslims for several centuries. For years, there were several attempts to expel them from Spanish territory, to make it entirely Catholic. These attempts provoked numerous battles. Over time, there was only one kingdom under Muslim rule, Granada. Isabella and Ferdinand, unhappy with this fact, sent a Christian army there to conquer the city. The sovereigns won and put pressure on the Muslim population. Many people were forced to flee. Now the challenge was to rule Granada. This was the end of Muslim rule on the Iberian Peninsula. Christopher Columbus, an Italian navigator renowned for conquering America, took advantage of the reign of the clever Isabella of Castile to execute an important project. For several years, he met with the queen to ask for help in making a voyage to the Indies, where he claimed it was possible to reach by sailing westward. This would be a very expensive voyage, and Columbus could not find anyone to finance it, as almost no one believed it could have a good outcome. After years of numerous attempts to get help, Isabella gave in and collaborated with the navigator on the voyage project. One of the reasons may have been the fact that Portugal, in this period, had several conquered lands. The queen did not want to see Spain behind. In addition, Isabella could accumulate wealth with the conquered lands, in addition to spreading the Catholic faith in these distant regions. and the power and prestige of the Queen of Castile would increase. On this voyage, whose goal was to reach the Indies, Columbus arrived in America on October the 12th, 1492. After this trip, Europeans were able to colonize lands in the American continent. In the 15th and 16th centuries, Portugal and Spain were in full maritime and commercial expansion. They were leading countries in the conquest and colonization process. But disputes arose over the newly discovered lands. An agreement was signed between Spain and Portugal, delimiting the lands conquered by both countries. This agreement became known as the Treaty of Tordesillas because it was signed in Tordesillas by representatives of the Portuguese and Spanish kingdoms. This took place in 1494, and the treaty was intended to avoid conflicts related to conquests in South America by Columbus and other explorers of the time. The demarcation was an imaginary line that divided South America. Spain would keep the conquest west of the line, and Portugal those in the east. For Spain, the 16th century became known as the Golden Century, as so many precious metals were found in the new continent. In the year of the signing of the Treaty of Tordesillas, Isabella of Castile and Ferdinand II of Aragon were awarded the title of Catholic monarchs by Pope Alexander VI. Given their numerous efforts to maintain religious unity in Spain. By this time, Isabella was over 40 years old, and the important thing was to secure the future of her children through marriages that would produce favorable alliances. The eldest daughter, Isabella, married Alfonso, son of Portugal's King John II. Alfonso died in an accident riding a horse, and the widow Isabella returned to her parents. After that, she married Manuel the Venturous, who became King of Portugal after the death of John II, whose cousin he was. John, the second son of the Catholic monarchs, married Margaret of Austria. Unfortunately, John, who was the favorite son of Isabella of Castile, and whose health was frail, died at age 20 of an unidentified disease, perhaps smallpox or tuberculosis. Overcome with grief, Elizabeth took it upon herself to care for her pregnant daughter-in-law, as she had a real affection for the girl, and hoped that a boy would be born to become the newest heir. But, to everyone's sorrow, Margaret had a miscarriage, and months later she returned to her home. Although Isabella and Ferdinand felt very downcast and unhappy about the situation, there was a new possibility of having an heir, because their firstborn, Isabella, was pregnant. However, they suffered another cruel blow. She gave birth to a boy, but could not regain her strength, and died. Following her mother's wish, the boy was given the name Miguel. Isabella of Castile and her husband, devastated by her loss of two children in a short time, put all their attention on the child, who would inherit Castile, Aragon, and Portugal. But Miguel was not in good health and was constantly ill. Despite the efforts and attention given, the child did not last long and died at the age of almost two. Once again, Isabella and Ferdinand tried to cope with the pain of the loss. The two were clearly shaken by the countless tragedies in the family. Maria of Aragon, sometime after Isabella's death, traveled to Portugal to marry her sister's widower. The last to marry was Catherine. Her first husband was Arthur, Prince of Wales, whom she married in 1501. However, 5 months after their marriage, she was widowed when she was only 16 years old. She then married Henry, Arthur's brother, who would become known as Henry VIII. Isabella of Castile, although she arranged marriages for all her daughters, was especially devoted to Joanna. The young woman had married Philip the Fair, Archduke of Austria and son of the Habsburg Emperor Maximilian, in 1496. In love with her husband, Joanna showed increasingly jealousy as he had several mistresses. Isabella of Castile, very concerned about her daughter's attitudes and suffering so much with the loss of her children and grandchildren, had a weakened health. She and her husband had fallen ill in July 1504. He recovered, but his wife did not. She was getting worse and worse, and more miserable. Isabella of Castile could not resist and died on November the 26th, 1504. The queen was succeeded by her daughter, Joanna. However, with obvious and progressive psychological disorders, power passed to her husband, Philip. But it did not last long, as he died a few months later. Joanna, considered insane by all, went to live in Tordesillas. Ferdinand took power again. He married once more in 1505, Germana Foy, niece of the King of France. In 1512, he conquered the Kingdom of Navarre, totally unifying Spain. Ferdinand died in 1516, and his successor was his grandson Charles I, son of Joan. An imposing, intelligent, ambitious, religious, and conservative figure, this Isabella of Castile, a queen who ruled with massive sturdiness and faith in God, keeping Christianity alive, loved and respected by many, but not so well liked by others. She was a very important female figure in history. Thanks to her, Spain became a respected European power, conquering territories in different parts of the world. The remains of the Catholic monarchs are in the Royal Chapel of Granada, as well as those of daughters Joanna and Isabella, and grandson Miguel.